Welcome to ME Summer Research Video. We are group R31, and our project was primarily aimed on a burner calibration system which is conducted at Zucker Propulsion Lab involving combustion and high-speed flows, as well as laser diagnostics and detonation principles. We're divided in three subgroups, where subgroup A focused on Henkin burner calibration, which is utilized in laser diagnostics and coherent anti-Stokes Raman spectroscopy. Subgroup B created a calibration flow system for molecular tagging, which is used for velocity measurements in harsh flow fields where physical sensors can be damaged. And subgroup C designed parametric modifications for rotating detonation combustor, which is utilized in super and hypersonic speeds.
The Henkin burner requires a portable design in order to be moved around the lab for various experiments, and should not take up too much space. We designed a portable system to hold the mass flow controllers, power supply, and DAC system. Additionally, spaces were added between the base and the mass flow controllers, as different types of controllers attach to surfaces differently. Each spacer has unique screw holes for the controller attachment and universal screw holes for attaching it to the base. This will allow the controllers to be replaced if one breaks or if a different flow rate is required. A 3D model was also created of the Henkin burner, with permanent plumbing attached to it to prevent excessive handling of the burner, preventing any potential damage. The system is designed to be attached to the lab's laser tables, with gases flowing from the mass flow controllers to the swage lock unions at the front of the burner setup.
In order to automate the Henkin burner's mass flow system, we implemented a data acquisition processing, which is controlled by LabVIEW in MATLAB, where the desired flow rate and equivalence ratio of the flame can be assigned to the controls without manual setting. It provides a more time-efficient work process, as well as helps to decrease the physical interaction with the burner, which increases its viability. As all required materials are ordered, our following step will include assembly of the portable burner system to test its effectiveness and determine if any alterations or debugging are required. As this system will be implemented, it will simplify burner installation procedure and ease the burner's usage in various experimental environments.
In R31B, we researched a form of molecular tagging velocimetry called FLASH, which is developed at Purdue. MTV is a method of mapping flow velocities, and it basically works by tagging molecules at some initial time and tracking these molecules sometime after.
This picture shows the final experimental setup that we used. We had the vacuum chamber, a high-speed camera used for collecting data, an intensifier to increase the resolution of the high-speed camera, and a sync counter so that both lasers will be firing at the same time. The two lasers that were used were the Solstice femtosecond laser and the 10 Hz laser, with the Solstice femtosecond laser acting at 800 Nm wavelength and the 10 Hz laser acting at 267 Nm wavelength.
MTV experiments resulted in images at varying read delays and varying amounts of signal. Among images with detectable signal, only a fraction of the image contained useful data. The MATLAB code was used to filter out parts without useful data, condense images into one averaged matrix, and create a plot of intensity versus read delay.
The primary outcomes of this experiment was to gain as much information as we possibly can so that it can be used in further real-life applications and tests.
In R031C, we have been working on improving injector design in Thor, one of Zucker's rotating detonation engines. RDEs are proposed engines that use detonation in self-sustaining shockwaves traveling continuously in an annular channel. This will give them high thermodynamic efficiency compared to traditional internal combustion engines and have many useful implications in aerospace engine technologies.
The problem with the current injection system is that it creates normal shocks in the channel, leading to a drastic drop in total pressure from throat to exhaust. This results in an inefficient engine. Our goal is to create a new injection system which minimizes total pressure loss as much as possible.
Our proposed injection system involves a ramp system with multiple steps at a given angle, which will create oblique shocks along the system from the throat to the exhaust and expansion fans respectively. And this will minimize the total pressure loss as compared to normal shocks. We designed a MATLAB function that returns the total pressure, static pressure, and Mach number given an input of the desired number of oblique shocks the user wants, and the ramp angle theta. As you can see in the bottom two pictures, you can see how the main function calls the subfunctions, which calculate some of the pressure ratios, Mach number, the various parameters we were talking about. Our future work and goals are that the algorithm returns the optimal number of shocks and theta in a visual surface plot, and this will be very useful for a manufacturer to construct the ramp system and to implement in the actual RDE.